Insecurities is something that run deep in all of us to some degree. Whether we got picked on for being too small or whether we got cracked on for being broke, whatever it may be, insecurities can plague us in ways that we are conscious of and unconscious of. I'm just here to talk about that, and this is the perfect video to break down how the insecurities may consciously affect you or unconsciously affect you. Stay tuned. My name is Cyrus Ausar, and my mission is to embody the emotion of overcoming. I believe we all fight battles we hide from the world. My objective is to help you win those battles through perspective. Stay tuned. Insecurities can run so deep. I mean, ridiculously deep. And it can come from various things, whether we got cracked on for being too small, whether we got joked on for being too tall, whether our family was poor, regardless of whatever it is. The insecurities can run deep, and we can be conscious of it, or we can be unconscious of it based on where it may stem from. Like when we grow up and if you grow up short, you get nicknames like shrimp and this guy is too small or whatever it may be. And it can affect you later on in life and you start feeling like you need to overcompensate for that. I need to overcompensate for being cracked on, being called small. I need to overcompensate for the fact that we grew up poor. I need to overcompensate or figure out a way to make myself look smaller because I'm too tall. And some of these insecurities we know we dealt with, and some of these insecurities we never dealt with. The fact that we didn't even know we had it until it hits you. And you're like, wait a minute, what is that? Or you feel some type of way. But I'm here to say, how to deal with these insecurities is to know that you don't have to fit the norm of what everybody else says. That's the reason why it'll plague you. It's because everybody is calling you short because they're taller than you. So what are you supposed to do? Just magically grow some inches? So now men is putting stuff in their shoes to be a little bit taller? Or whatever the case may be, it's always something to make sure the crowd is okay with your image. If you're too skinny, now it's about how do I put on the right clothes? How do I make sure I look like this? If you're too fat, now you want to, how do I cut down? And how can I do this? And how can I make myself not look like what I am? We see these insecurities happen so much and plague our society so much and get in our brain. I know so many women as, well, you know what? How can I get a bigger butt? How can I get butt shots? How can I get chest implants? How can I get all these? Because it can run deep. Based on what we see this in society says it's okay. This is what it's supposed to be. Now it's to a point that we feel like now I have to be what society says that I am supposed to be. And when I am not, I am insecure. I don't want to wear this type of clothes because I don't want people to look at this. You know, I don't even want to be myself. I want to try my best to fit the mold of what society says the mode of beauty is. And it can plague us. To a point, as I said, somebody can be short their whole life. Now they figure out ways to get platform shoes and hide the fact that they got it. They got lifts that you can put in regular tennis shoes. People try any angle possible to feel like they can fit in with the crowd. They don't want to be cracked on. Listen, embrace who you are. Be yourself to the purest form. I know that's easy for somebody to just say because when you're going out here and you feel some type of way, but no matter what, you will never fit in with what society believes you should be. Soon as you correct one, it's going to be something else. Soon as you correct that, it's going to be something else. And it's a never-ending cycle. So how do you break that cycle early? By embracing who you are. By embracing who you are. Insecurities can run so deep that you won't even realize that that's the reason you're doing what you do. Oh, I don't even want to. It's a party I really want to go to. Man, I don't really want to go because, you know, I ain't lose enough weight. What? You didn't lose enough weight? That's the reason why you don't want to go somewhere that you really want to go? Because you're afraid of what somebody may or may not say? That just doesn't even make any sense. But this is the society that we're living in. So what I'm saying is embrace who you are at all times. Because everybody got something to say and nobody's perfect. No matter, look at who criticized stuff. No matter what they criticize, they got something wrong with them too. It's something that you can say. Look at people that write columns and criticize everything. You might have somebody to criticize movies, say this movie was horrible, give it thumbs down, all that, and never did a movie a day in their life. You got somebody that will criticize LeBron James and never picked up a basketball a day in their life. You got somebody that will criticize clothing, but they never been poor. They don't know how to do certain things or criticize weight. They don't know that you was eating properly and you just don't know how, or the weight ain't falling off the way you want, or you can't do nothing about being tall or being short. You cannot let these people dictate your life because they feel like you need to fit in a box that they don't even fit in. They don't even fit in. You can watch one of them shows where they criticize what somebody would wear on the red carpet. Oh, they should have wore this. Oh, I don't know why they wore that. And then you look at what they're wearing. You're like, I wouldn't even wear what you're wearing. But these are the people that can dictate how we think about ourselves. We let these insecurities grow and manifest within us to a point it dictates our actions. I'm here to say this. It is critical to embrace who you are, period. If you are overweight, I ain't telling you don't lose weight or whatever the case is. That's up to you. If you feel like you want to be healthy or you feel like this would make me feel better or whatever that is. I can't tell you not to do something if it's going to make you feel a little bit better based on health reasons or based on whatever reasons you truly feel better inside. But don't let it be an external force that's saying this is why you need to do it. This is why you need to look taller. This is why you need to lose weight. This is why. Don't let the external force dictate it for you. If you feel like you want to change it because you want to, that's something else. But when you're talking about changing something because everybody else say you need to, no. You can't allow that to affect who you are as a person. And that continuously happens. And then now what happens? Now I'm just going everywhere with my life, everywhere somebody tell me I need to go. It doesn't matter how I feel to myself. But you have to deal with you at the end of every night. It's you that got to deal with you. So you embrace you under all circumstances. Do not let these insecurities manifest and overtake your life because other people feel like you need to live like something else. Other people feel like you need to look like something else to a point that now you second guess who you are as a person. You know what I'm saying? So don't allow this to happen to you. If you like this video or you can relate, please share it with somebody that you know can get this message. Like, comment, subscribe. Thank you.